Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum. A very good day to you all. In today's video, I'm going to talk about reinforced learning. Okay, my name is Professor Maria Dr. Ahmad Muhyiddin bin Helmi. I'm the co-founder of Sovetesis, which I created myself. And my brother, Ahmad Zaim, he is the programmer for the Sovetesis. Okay, in this video, I'm going to talk about reinforced learning because I have studied a lot of books. I made a lot of books related to engineering, reinforced learning. The name reinforced learning comes in most of my book. So in my opinion, it is an important part for those who are studying research on material handling for manufacturing sector. This or for person who are studying robotics. This reinforcement learning, you will always encounter the name reinforcement learning in your studies. So I just want to make an explanation of what is reinforced learning. Okay, reinforcement learning is learning through interaction. Okay, reinforcement learning involves agent interacting with its environment to maximize cognitive rewards. Okay, it is different from supervised learning. Unlike supervised learning, reinforced learning doesn't rely on labeled data. The agent learns from consequences of its action. It is a goal-oriented learning. The agent's goal is to learn on a strategy that maximizes the overall rewards created over time. Okay. You can imagine this reinforced learning is like when you see your child or you yourself, which you can remember when we are a little boy, little girl, back during our childhood time, we learn to walk. Okay, when we learn to walk, we fall down, and then we stand up, then we walk again, then we fall down and we stand up. This is reinforced learning. Okay, if we don't learn to how to stand up, we don't learn how to walk, we do not know how to walk. Okay, this is called reinforcement learning. And what is the agent? The agent in this mention in the definition of reinforced learning. The agent in my example is our parent, is our guardian. Our parent, they supervise us on us walking, falling down and come up again, and walking again and fall down again. This is called reinforced learning, and the agent in this case is our parent or our guardian and everything lah. This is an example of reinforced learning. Okay, so the key concept of reinforced learning, there is an agent, which is the learner or decision maker that interact with the environment. Like I just said, it's in the example they given below, that the agent in this case of us when we are in childhood, we walk and we fall down and we walk and we fall down again. The agent is our parent. Okay. And the learner is ourselves. Yeah. The environment is the external system that agents interact with, providing feedback or rewards or punishment. Okay. Another example, maybe some of you have experienced before, you are playing with fire, you are playing with knife, your parent strongly advise you against playing with fire, playing with knife, and then you as childhood, you don't know anything, you touch the fire and you feel burn and you feel pain, and then this is what the learning process, and then you don't repeat it again like in Malay words, in Bahasa Melayu, word is called baru adakai, kan? Okay, when you playing with fire, when you feel hurt, then you baru adakai. Okay, okay, that is the state and action. The current situation that an agent can observe, state where the set of all possible move against the agent can make action. Reward the immediate feedback received from the environment after an action is performed. Okay. Like in this case, in the programming sector, it is given as a 0 and 1. 1 is a reward, 0 is not, no reward. Okay, this is a programming, but in real life, in if I take a this situation like as a childhood back in your childhood days, the reward is the ice cream, the reward is the praise from your parents, say good everything, okay? The policy and value function and strategy to determine the next action of policy and functions estimating of long-term benefit of states, like us lah, when we know how to walk, then we know we want to learn how to ride a bicycle, how to ride a motorcycle and everything lah, kan? Okay, how reinforcement learning works, okay? It is exploration versus exploitation, balancing the act of exploring new action versus exploiting known action to maximize rewards. Okay, the learning process, the agent observe the state, chooses an action, receive feedback and update its knowledge to improve decision. The goal of reinforced learning is to learn a policy that maximize cognitive reward over time to iterative experience. Okay, this is how reinforcement learning works. Some types of reinforced learning algorithms, okay, they are cue learning and of policy algorithm that updates the cue value based on reward and maximum cue value of the state. The deep cue network, DQN, combines cue learning with deep learning using neural networks to handle large state space. Policy gradient methods optimize the policy directly by adjusting its parameters based on the gradient of expected rewards. Proximal policy optimization, PPO, a policy gradient method that enhances the stability and performance by limiting the policy update steps, and SARSA, SARSA, and on policy algorithm that updates cue value based on action taken, the next action to be taken. Okay, so the application of reinforced learning, okay, there are many, but given only three here. Okay, there is in the robotics. Reinforced learning enables robot to learn and adapt to complex tasks and environments through trial and error. You can see robots nowadays, you can type in YouTube, type in Google, and everything, there are many robots, working, walking robot, jumping and everything. Those robot, they learn, imagine the robot is like a child lah. They do not know how to walk, and then they learn how to walk. They do not know how to jump, they learn how to jump. This is a robot game playing. Okay, like for those who are like play games, okay, like the example given here, like Go, G-O, Go and Atari. Okay, the game, Go and Atari, also many other games lah, because when we play the game, we know how to are familiar with the all the control environment. We know how to play the game, okay? And autonomous vehicles, reinforcement learning is for better in developing self-driving cars, allowing them to navigate and make decision in real time the environment. So we see the modern cars, the self-driving cars, okay? There's in USA like the Tesla car, or in mainland China, there are self-driving cars and everything. Okay, maybe in the near future there will be such cars in our place lah. Okay, so they all learn about from autonomous learning. Okay, so that's all for the video today. Inshallah, I hope you learn something today. Inshallah, we meet you in again in the next video. Thank you very much.